Becoming a member of the US Special Operations Forces isn't just a career choice. It's a life-defining transformation. It demands unmatched physical strength, unwavering mental resilience, and the ability to adapt and perform in the most extreme environments. These are the elite, sent into the toughest, most high-stakes missions. From precision raids under moonless skies to covert reconnaissance deep behind enemy lines, their work is relentless and unforgiving. But even the most highly trained operators rely on the right tools to succeed. When every second counts and the stakes couldn't be higher, the need for reliable, versatile transportation becomes crucial. Whether cutting through rugged terrain, skimming silently over water, or flying into hostile zones, these warriors need the fastest, most advanced, and dependable equipment to ensure mission success. Let's dive into the heart of the vehicles that enable Special Operations Forces to dominate any environment, anywhere in the world, and explore why their missions demand only the best in battlefield mobility, on land, through the air, and across the sea. Enter the M1297 Army Ground Mobility Vehicle, or AGMV, which is a US Army airdroppable light offload vehicle for light infantry bridges. The vehicle is built by General Dynamics on the basis of that firm's Flyer 72. The modular vehicle can be customized according to mission requirements, which range from deep reconnaissance to strike missions, and various enclosed and open-top configurations are available. Depending on configuration, accommodation ranges from 3 to 9 operators. The GMV 1.1 features an enhanced Victronics capability, ready to plug into current and future battlefield networks. The 5.33-meter-long vehicle has a curb weight of 3,100 kilos. The payload capacity is 2,800 kilos. The integrated roll cage can withstand 100% of the vehicle weight, preventing a turned-over GMV from crushing the crew. External storage boxes on each of the 4 passenger doors increase storage capacity while also adding ballistic and blast protection. Although the vehicle can accommodate a 30mm cannon, the standard armament configuration includes a central ring mount with a choice of 12.7mm machine gun, 7.62mm minigun, or 40mm automatic grenade launcher. Mobility characteristics include the ability to climb a 60% gradient and master a dynamic slide slope of 40%. Road speed is limited to 120 kilometers per hour, with a cruising range of nearly 500 kilometers at mission profile or 800 kilometers on flat ground at 70 kilometers per hour. The vehicle is envisioned as the 21st century Jeep, capable of moving troops around during an initial attack faster than the enemy's heavy weapons can counter. Internal transport of the GMV 1.1 is possible via fixed-wing tactical aircraft and helicopter. When it comes to the US military's most daring operations, the 160th Special Operations Aviation Regiment, or SOC-R, known as the Night Stalkers, emerges as a key player. Central to their arsenal are the agile and resilient MH-6 Little Bird and its armed sibling, the AH-6. These helicopters have become legendary for their precision, adaptability, and steadfast performance in high-stakes missions where success is the only option. The MH-6 Little Bird epitomizes stealth and versatility. Dubbed the Killer Egg due to its compact and unassuming shape, it is designed for fast, low-altitude flights, making it the ideal choice for inserting and extracting special forces in complex, high-risk environments. With its lightweight frame and superior maneuverability, the MH6 can weave through urban landscapes and dense terrains with ease, often under the cover of darkness. The sight of an MH6 swooping in, barely above the treetops, remains an iconic image of the US Special Operations Theater. The AH-6 variant takes the MH6's stealth and adds teeth. Designed for light attack missions, this agile platform carries a formidable array of weaponry, including machine guns, rocket pods, and grenade launchers. Its armament transforms the helicopter from a covert transport vehicle to an agile precision strike aircraft capable of neutralizing threats before ground forces can make contact. This adaptability makes the AH-6 indispensable during direct action missions, providing close air support and reconnaissance. The MH-6 and AH-6 are equipped with powerful Allison 250 C30 turboshaft engines, ensuring they have the speed and climb rate necessary for unpredictable mission requirements. The combination of lightweight airframes and efficient power plants enables a maximum speed of around 175 miles per hour and an operational ceiling of over 16,000 feet. This technical agility complements the rigorous training of their pilots, often considered among the most skilled in the world, who are adept at flying these helicopters in the tightest of spaces and most hazardous conditions. While the mastery of land and air gives Special Operations Forces the agility to strike swiftly and adapt to complex terrains, the true dominance in the field requires seamless transition across every domain, including the vast, unpredictable expanse of the seas and rivers. Now, imagine the thrill, the roar of the engines as you throttle up, the spray of salt water in your face as you cut through the waves, the tension building as you approach that shadowy coastline. This is where the real action unfolds. Get ready, because we're about to dive headfirst into the world of SWCCs. Their incredible boats, their weaponry, and what it takes to be one of these elite naval warriors. Special Warfare Combatant-Craft Crewmen, or SWCCs, and their special boat teams are the backbone of naval special warfare. Their primary role is to stealthily insert and extract SEALs and other special operations forces into hostile coastal and riverine environments. This includes conducting direct action raids, reconnaissance missions, riverine patrols, countering enemy vessels, and even combat search and rescue. SWCCs master high-performance boats and weapons systems and work as a tight-knit team, handling intense conditions with both physical and mental toughness. The Special Warfare Combatant Craft Crewmen, or SWCCs, operate a variety of specialized equipment with a significant focus on their unique fleet of boats designed for high speed, stealth, and versatility in special operations missions. These boats are central to the SWCCs' ability to insert, extract, and support special operations forces in environments where conventional Navy vessels cannot operate.
Hands, hands, hands on the front!
Here's a detailed look at some of the key equipment, particularly the boats used by the SWCC. Manufactured by US Marine Incorporated, the Special Operations Craft-Riverine, or SOC-R, is a high-performance craft deployed by the United States Navy, or USN, and the United States Marine Corps, or USMC, for a variety of critical missions. This formidable vessel comes equipped with a powerful arsenal, including two GAU-17 miniguns, one M2HB 50 caliber machine gun, two M240B 7.62mm light machine guns, and two 40mm Mark 19 grenade launchers, making it well-suited for short-range insertion and extraction of Special Operations Forces, or SOF, in both riverine and littoral environments. Additionally, the SOC-R serves the US Navy's riverine forces for tasks such as inshore interdiction, riverine patrolling, and direct action missions. Powered by two 440-horsepower Yanmar 6LY2M STE diesel engines, each driving a Hamilton HJ292 water pump jet, the SOC-R boasts a top speed of 40 knots and a range of 125 nautical miles. It has a crew composition of four Special Warfare Combatant-Craft Crewmen, including one helmsman and three gunners, and it has the capacity to carry eight SOF personnel. Remarkably, the craft is designed for air transport, capable of being airlifted aboard C-130 or larger military aircraft, ensuring rapid deployment and flexibility in operations across the globe. The SOC-R is all about conquering rivers with their varying depths and obstacles. Its design prioritizes the ability to operate where larger vessels simply cannot. This requires a flat-bottomed hull and adjustable propulsion systems. Unlike propeller-driven boats, the SOC-R utilizes powerful water jets. These draw in water and expel it at high velocity, providing excellent maneuverability and reducing the risk of damage from underwater debris common in riverine environments. While the SOC-R is capable of impressive speeds, its focus is on agility. Sharp turns, navigating narrow channels, and even reversing direction rapidly are key to operating in ever-changing river conditions. The heart of the SOC-R's adaptability lies in its adjustable water jet system. This likely implies hydraulic mechanisms to raise or lower propulsion units, drastically altering the vessel's draft on the fly. A blend of strength and weight savings is paramount. Aluminum remains the primary material, but is reinforced with strategically placed composites for added structural rigidity in critical areas. River operations are inherently unpredictable. From submerged obstacles to potential ambushes along the shoreline, a SOC-R crew is constantly scanning their environment, ready to react at a moment's notice. For this reason, the SOC-R's sensor suite prioritizes situational awareness in complex terrain. Short to medium range radar assists in navigating twists and turns and spotting potential dangers or other vessels on the river. Integration with digital maps and GPS is crucial for precise navigation and mission planning. Some SOC-Rs might be equipped for night operations. The SOC-R's emphasis on maneuverability means limited internal space. Crew members work in close proximity, demanding seamless coordination and constant communication. Riverine environments can mean harsh sun, driving rain, and ever-changing temperatures. The crew of a SOC-R needs to be prepared for rapidly shifting weather conditions. Thank you. This concludes our episode that provides a glimpse into some of the vehicles US Special Forces use on their missions. So, what do you think about these remarkable vehicles? What other pieces of military hardware would you like us to cover in our future episodes? Also, if you are lucky enough to see these vehicles up close, or better yet, operate in one, please comment. Remember to hit the subscribe button and ring that bell to stay updated with our latest content. And while you're here, why not check out another one of our exciting videos? Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.